Good morning. This is your new day. It's Tuesday, January 20th, 6 o'clock in the East almost. A new ISIS video threatens to kill two Japanese hostages, but a new twist. The terror group says it won't perform the cowardly acts it normally does if it receives a $200 million ransom in the next 72 hours. This exchanging of perverse principle for cash just posted on militant websites this morning. Once again showing, as you see, a black-clad terrorist speaking with a British accent, wielding a knife.
The hostages seen in orange jumpsuits include a freelance journalist and a man reportedly kidnapped in Syria after going there to train with militant fighters. The terrorist directly addresses Japan's prime minister, who is demanding the release of the hostages and calls the threat, quote, unforgivable. Let's get right to CNN's Will Ripley in Beijing for the very latest. What do we know, Will?
Allison, we know that Prime Minister Shinzo Abe spoke within the last hour about this, and he says that terrorists need to be dealt with. He expressed outrage about this video showing two citizens of Japan kneeling in between a man with a voice that many of our viewers may find familiar, a voice believed to be Jihadi John of ISIS. I'm going to play for you what he has to say, and then I'll explain why we believe he's demanding what he is.
To the Prime Minister of Japan, although you are more than 8,500 kilometers away from the Islamic State, you willingly have volunteered to take part in this crusade.
So Prime Minister Abe is in the Middle East right now, and just 2 days ago, he pledged $200 million in support to fight ISIS. And then 2 days later, ISIS takes these two Japanese hostages, Kenji Goto, who is believed to have been taken sometime after October 23rd. That's the last time the freelance journalist posted on his Twitter account. He was a war zone reporter covering the conflict in the Middle East. Haruna Yukawa, 42 years old, owner of a private security company. He was taken in August. It's believed that ISIS was holding these two men. And then just 2 days after the prime minister says Japan is pledging $200 million, suddenly this video appears with a well-known executioner seen on tape killing two Americans and two British citizens, now demanding $200 million to ISIS in exchange for the lives of these Japanese men. It gives us some insight, Allison, into how this group continues to operate.
It does. Will, thanks so much for all that information.